Hi everyone. This tutorial shows how to use an AlphaFold model for molecular replacement. In particular, it illustrates the case when a model has been predicted without templates or homolog structures. Our example uses data from the protein POMGNT2. In February 2021, when the first AlphaFold database was trained on models in the PDB, no detectable homologs of POMGNT2 were available, and the structure was not yet published. Since then, two groups determined the structure of POMGNT2. We will use the diffraction data from one of these structures for our tutorial. If you are new to using molecular replacement, it may be useful to watch the MR video tutorial first. To set up the example data, open the Phenix GUI and click on New Project. In the new window, click on Setup Tutorial Data and another window appears. Open the drop-down menu next to Tutorial Data. Go down to Molecular Replacement and choose POMGNT2. Indicate a directory where the data are to be saved. Then click OK to save the changes. Predicted models often come with residue-by-residue estimates of uncertainty. We can use this information to remove low-confidence residues and break the model into domains. Let's have a look at the AlphaFold model of POMGNT2. We can visually separate the structure into three domains. The yellow colors in the model tell us that the residues connecting the domains have low confidence. The predicted aligned error plot then can tell us how certain the relative positions of the domains are. We see that there are three domains, represented by the three dark green areas along the diagonal in the plot. Each corresponds to a domain that we visually identified in the structure, and AlphaFold is confident about the distances between all pairs of residues within each domain. The small square in the upper left corresponds to the long helix in the right, the large square in the center of the plot corresponds to the large domain in the middle, and the square in the lower right represents the smaller domain on the left. The light green areas away from the diagonal in the plot suggest that the relative orientations of the domains are uncertain. So before doing molecular replacement, we will use the Process Predicted Model tool to break the model into domains. Note that the model preparation step should always be carried out, even if there are no domains, because it's essential to translate the confidence measure stored in the B-factor field. The confidence measure, or PLDDT, goes from 0 to 100 for bad to good, but if it's interpreted as a B-factor, it will give the strongest weight to the worst parts of the model. The Process Predicted Model task translates the PLDDT into a B-factor that appropriately downweighs the worst parts of the model. Go to the Phenix GUI. In the panel on the right-hand side, choose AlphaFold and then Process Predicted Model. For bookkeeping, put a job title. To enter the predicted model, click Browse and choose AFQ8NAT1F1 Model version 1 PDB. Then click on Optional Input Files and click Browse next to the PAE File Input field. Choose the .json file in the tutorial directory, which contains the predicted aligned error matrix. Click OK to close the window. We leave all other parameters at their defaults, then click Run to start the program. Once finished, the program has separated the AlphaFold model into the three chains, A1, A2, and A3. We will ignore chain A1. The long helical domain, as it corresponds to a membrane anchor helix that was left out of the soluble construct made for crystallization. Note that the program also purged some low confidence residues from the model. It also indicates the number of residues in each domain. We will now use the program PDB tools to create two separate model files, one for chain A2 and one for chain A3. In the main Phenix window, go to Models, Modification, Minimization and Dynamics. Then choose PDB Tools. Enter a job title. Click Add File and choose the output file from the Process Predicted Model program. Choose an output file name, such as Domain 2. Go to the Options tab and put Chain A2 into the Keep Only Atom Selection field. Click Run. When it is finished, run the program again, this time with the selection Chain A3. And don't forget to change the output file name to Domain 3. The output files will be in separate subfolders in your tutorial directory. Now we are ready to run molecular replacement. In the main Phenix window, choose Molecular Replacement and then PhaserMR Full Featured. For bookkeeping, give your job a title. Ensure that the phaser mode is automated molecular replacement. Then we add the file with the diffraction data. Phenix automatically populates the unit cell and the space group fields from the file. Quickly check to ensure that the correct information is used. Then go to the Ensembles tab. In this run, we will only use one model for each component, but you can use an ensemble of alternative models when you run MR on your data. We start by defining the first domain. Give the first search model a name, here Domain 2. Click on Add File to add the model file. Let's change the estimated error, or variance. We will specify it with an RMSD of 1 angstrom. Then click OK. Now let's add the second search model. Click the Add PDB Ensemble button and then click on Ensemble 2. We name this one Domain 3 and this time we add the file Domain 3 PDB. Again, the RMSD is 1 angstrom. Go to the ASU Contents tab. For each molecule in the asymmetric unit, we tell phaser whether it is protein or nucleic acid and how many copies exist. The size of each component can be specified in a number of ways, but it is usually most convenient to use the sequence of the protein you crystallized. Make sure the chain type is set to protein. Change the number of copies to 2, specify the ASU contents as sequence file, and select the file with the sequence of the construct. In the Search Procedure tab, we tell phaser how to use the ensembles. Next to Component 1, click on the ellipsis. Choose Add Ensemble and Add Domain 2. We search for 2 copies of Domain 2. To search also for the other domain, click on Add Search and Add a Component. Clicking on the ellipsis, we choose Domain 3 as second component. Search for 2 copies. Click Run to start the job. The GUI will update the Run Status and Graph tabs. After about 10 minutes, phaser has found one solution with a very high LLG and TFZ. We can be reasonably confident that this solution is correct. If we don't break the model into domains and use instead the AlphaFold model as is, then phaser can still find a solution in this case. However, the small domain is not well placed, as can be seen in this screenshot. The residues do not fit the density. When we overlay the deposited model from the PDB, we see that the orientation of the small domain is different. To fix this, significant manual work or rebuilding is needed. In contrast, when we search for 2 domains, the residues fit the density very well. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions, contact us at help@phoenix-online.org or tutorials@phoenix-online.org.